Every year, millions of Shias from around the globe come to join the sea of the lovers of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. If you take part in this gathering once during the time of Arba'een, then it will be very difficult for you to be at the shrine when it is calm and uncrowded, because you will feel like it is only at the time of Arba'een that the Imam is paid the respect that he deserves. During Arba'een, no one enters the shrine quietly. Everyone is beating their chests and their heads in the sorrow of Hussein alayhi salam, shedding tears and wailing in the loss of their beloved Imam. The crowd of millions shout, "Labbaik ya Hussein, labbaik ya Hussein, here I am, O Hussein." But history has led these lovers of the Imam into the deserts of Karbala 1,400 years later. You might think to yourself that I can send my salams to Hussein alayhi salam from my home too. I can recite the Ziyarat Arba'een at home too. Why should I give myself so much hardship and walk such a long distance in the hot and cold weather to visit someone who is with me even this second? Then listen to the word of Lady Zainab, who said to Yazid, "By Allah, you cannot destroy and do away with our remembrance and memory." Then if I say salam from my own house, and you send salams from your own house, it won't take too long for the tragedy of Karbala to be forgotten.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah. Welcome to the program Labbaik ya Hussein. We are approaching the 40th of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, which is called Arba'een. Right now, many believers, lovers, and followers of the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam are traveling from far distances so that they can walk from Najaf, the holy city of Najaf, where Imam Ali alayhi salam is born, to the holy shrine of Imam Hussein, which is located in Karbala. This is about a 50-mile journey that people take walking for about 2 or 3 days. It is one of the largest gatherings of the world, peaceful gatherings of people in the world. There are some larger gatherings. There's maybe only one other larger gathering, but that happens maybe every 6 or 12 years. This is the largest gathering of people that happens every year. Some say that in 2018, we had about 30 million people come and to visit the shrine of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. So this is a very big event. It should be recorded in the news. It should be worldwide. And we should ask ourselves, why are 30 million people, as according to some sources, gathering to come to visit Imam Hussein alayhi salam's shrine, walking about a very long journey, almost 50 miles, around 50 miles, and sleeping in tents and sacrificing either their money, their time, coming to participate in this holy event? One of the reasons is that Imam Hussein alayhi salam attracts people. And as we look at the narrations, when you look at the visitation of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, we have narrations from Imam Muhammad al-Baqir, the fifth Imam alayhi salam, saying that لَوْ يَعْلَمُ النَّاسِ مَا فِي زِيَارَةِ قَبْرِ الْحُسَيْنِ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ مِنَ الْفَضْلِ, if people were to know how much virtue there was in the visitation of Imam Hussein, لَمَاتُوا شَوْقًا, they would have died, they would die because of shawq and because of dear love and attachment and happiness and joy for Imam Hussein alayhi salam that they have. So this is one of the reasons that people visit Imam Hussein. Imam Hussein attracts us. The love of Imam Hussein alayhi salam is a fire that burns the hearts of the believers. And if we truly knew how great his ziyarat was, we would die out of love, out of happiness for what is anticipates us in the hereafter. When we look at this ziyarat of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, when we look at Arba'een, we see that how is it possible to feed, say, 20 million, 30 million people? How is it possible to give shelter to 20, 30 million people? This, if was a task, if a government was tasked to do this, it would maybe be impossible for a government to do such a thing in terms of logistics. Because this is the will of the people, because this is done out of sheer love for Imam Hussein, we see that he himself, Imam Hussein alayhi salam, he himself helps and facilitates all the needs of his visitors. So in terms of logistics, it is a miracle for us to see that 20, 30 million people are being fed. 20, 30 million people are having shelter. And this shows us that when people gather and they have one goal and they have one thing in their mind, when they gather together and are united, that they could do things that even governments cannot do. And this is done out of people's own expense. It is something very, is something voluntary. When you go to the country of Iraq and you see people that are many times their financial situation is not that great, but they give in the way of Imam Hussein and Arba'een in a way that you think they're millionaires. So this again is another miracle that you see that people out of love of Imam Hussein are giving from Najaf all the way, even from earlier, from even the borders of the countries, you see that there are places where food is distributed, water, and whatever a zawar or za'ir needs, or whatever a visitor needs is facilitated for them. This is because that humans are gathering with one goal, with one purpose, out of love for Imam Hussein. And this for us is a lesson to learn that inshallah, in the same way you'll see people will reunite for the love of Imam Mahdi, ajallahu ta'ala farajah. And we see that this could be a prelude to the coming of Imam Mahdi, because people are gathering, people are sacrificing, people are respecting one another, people are giving the most respect to the visitor of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. So this is a miraculous event that we see, even though Arba'een happened in history before, people did visit the shrine of Imam Hussein alayhi salam on the 40th, and we'll talk about that. But in this way, after the fall of Saddam, this way that in this 20, 30 million people, in this numbers, and this way that we see alhamdulillah happening, this is a very good sign for us. This is something, inshallah, that is accepted by the visitors of Imam Hussein, accepted by those that help out in terms of money, in terms of giving services to the visitors of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And this is very good news for us. And inshallah, we can be of those that are recorded to have visited Imam Hussein alayhi salam in Arba'een. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ahl baytihi at-tayyibin at-tahirin.